Sisqo summed it up pretty well when he screamed, "That thong, the thong, thong, thong!" Because no undergarment has ever captured our national attention like the G-string. And over the past half century, the thong has transitioned from a sexually charged outfit into an everyday staple for millions of people who want to avoid panty lines or just look a little extra at the beach. This is how the mayor of New York City, Monica Lewinski, and yes, obviously Sisqo, helped turn the thong from novelty lingerie into a 21st century icon. About 75,000 years ago, the earliest predecessor of the thong and underwear in general are loincloths made from animal hides. Fast forward to the late 1800s. For most people, underwear consists of puffy, lacy bloomers, but early versions of the jockstrap, worn by athletes like fighters and strongmen, feature a strap that fits snugly between the cheeks. Though the thong, as we know it, isn't introduced until 1939. The World's Fair in New York City features burlesque dancers that please pretty much everyone except Mayor Fiorello La Guardia, who ordered the risque performers cover up their nether regions. To get around the mayor's decree, dancers designed a barely there underwear solution that exposes the butt but censors the private parts. Thus, the thong is born. Over the next 30 years, thongs and their slightly raunchier cousin, the G-string, are pretty much limited to exotic dancers. But in the 1970s, Austrian-American avant-garde fashion designer Rudi Gernreich develops the thong bathing suit as a suitable middle ground between traditional swimwear and being naked. And while the fashion world and desperate lifeguards at nude beaches took notice, the bathing suit only really caught on in Latin American countries like Brazil. In the 1980s, Frederick Mellinger, famed owner of lingerie icon Fredericks of Hollywood and inventor of the push-up bra, begins selling thong underwear under the very questionable name Scanty Panties. The undergarment was on shelves alongside edible and crotchless panties, and is still considered a novelty steeped in sexuality for most. But slowly and surely, people discover that the barely there butt floss helps solve the visible panty line problem, commonly known as VPL. In 1989, Cher releases her legendary video for the song If I Could Turn Back Time, featuring the singer shimmying across the deck of the USS Missouri in a black thong. In 1998, the thong steadily gains steam with consumers and receives a moment of national attention during the Bill Clinton-Monica Lewinsky scandal. The Star report, which details the president's affair with Lewinsky, includes a much-publicized tidbit noting, "In the course of flirting with Bill Clinton, she raised her jacket in the back and showed him the straps of her thong underwear." On the heels of the story, thong sales nearly double, and stores like J. Crew, Victoria's Secret, and even Walmart begin stocking thongs. But G-string culture wouldn't hit a fever pitch until 1999. Singer Mark Andrews, better known as Sisqo, branches out on a solo career after multiple platinum hits with his R&B group Drew Hill. His debut album, Unleash the Dragon, receives tepid reviews and moderate success until the release of its second single. Featuring a string sample of a cover of Eleanor Rigby and an instantly iconic music video, the thong song is an immediate smash hit and has everyone from 11-year-olds watching TRL to suburban housewives at the gym singing about dumps like a truck, thighs like what, and an overall adoration of the thong. In a 2017 InStyle article, Sisqo explains the inspiration behind the song, a date in the late 90s that apparently went very well. He says, quote, "We started to get all hot and heavy. She got undressed and, lo and behold, I see something that I've never seen before. I was shell-shocked." Throughout the mid-2000s, hundreds of millions of thongs are being sold every year, and the increasingly gross and exploitative paparazzi heavily document female celebrities wearing thongs, which, on a very related note, free Britney! In 2006, Sacha Baron Cohen's Borat brought the thong monokini to the silver screen. In 2014, Rihanna wears a visible thong to the CFDA Fashion Awards. And Nicki Minaj notably wears a pink G-string on the cover of her single Anaconda and in its music video. However, in 2015, we start to see a thong backlash. Sales dip, granny panties rise, and people start to reject the wearing of thongs as a way to reduce panty lines because, well, they'd rather be comfortable. I get it, damn it! But still, hundreds of millions of thongs are sold every year, and they coexist with other undergarments for individuals of all genders as an everyday option. So we salute you, thongs. Thanks for making our music videos a little more risque, our teenage trips to Abercrombie and Fitch a little more exciting, and our panty lines a lot less visible for people who care about that stuff. Now, if you'll excuse me, I need to go Google what dumps like a truck means. Hey y'all, if you like this video, make sure to subscribe to our channel and comment on what you want us to cover next. We might not actually do it, but we'll definitely read the comment. Thanks!